Welcome to CA Raja classes. This session or this video is exclusive for exporters. For exporters, there are various incentive schemes by government. There are various promotional schemes. But the problem is many are not aware of it. So this session is going to focus on one such incentive or promotion that is available for exporters, and they can get a real benefit out of it. What is that? Let's get started. Let me share my screen. Yeah, I hope my screen is visible. So, attention exporters, have you heard of duty credit scripts? If not, this session will take you through. What do I mean by duty credit scripts? See, this duty credit script is basically an incentive or say export promotion benefit launched by Government of India to incentivize exporters. So it is a scheme where the focus is to give benefit to the exporters, give them incentive. But how it is being done? It is done by way of a script, and this script can be used for paying customs duty. It means when exporter export their goods or services, they are going to earn the script, and they can use that script for either paying their customs duties or even some other benefits are available. So who is entitled or who is eligible for getting the script? Obviously, they have to be an exporter, and it can be either exporter of goods or even exporter of services also. So whether all export of goods and services are included, answer is no. There are certain restrictions, but there are many benefits. Okay, let's see one by one. I said this scheme is available for both exporter of goods and services. First, let's focus on services. For services, there is a scheme called SEIS. You can see on the screen, it is Service Exports from India scheme. So this scheme focuses mainly on service providers who are exporting their services. So it promotes export of services. Here, the exporters are eligible to get this duty script credit when they make eligible exports. So within quotes, eligible exports, not all exports are eligible. Only there are certain specified exports, right? And the condition is service provider should be located in India, and all eligible exports are eligible for getting this script. Let's see. What is the eligibility criteria? See, we said there are eligible exports. That is on one side. On the other side, that exporter, if he wants to claim this, he should be an eligible person. So what is that criteria? Number one, service provider should be located in India, but he should come under notified service provider. That's why I said not all service providers, only the specified service providers, that is notified service providers. So this service provider can be in the form like company or limited liability partnership or partnership firm. Even individual sole proprietors is also included. And the condition is like this. If you want to claim this script, you should have earned a minimum net foreign exchange earnings of $15,000, and this should be in the preceding financial year. So if you are an exporter of service, if you want to claim, first of all, you should come under notified services. Number two, if you are a company or LLP or partnership firm, you should have minimum net foreign exchange earnings of $15,000 in the previous year. So within quotes, this amount criteria, that is $15,000, is applicable only for company, LLP, partnership. It means I said even sole proprietors, individuals, they can also go for the script, but for them, the minimum criteria is slightly lesser than this. What is that? Have a look at this. Proprietorships, individual service providers, they should have minimum $10,000 in the preceding financial year as their minimum net foreign exchange earnings. If so, they are eligible. And another important criteria, they should have an active IE code. IE code means import-export code, and they should have this code when? At the time of rendering those services. So this is the prerequisite, and without this, he's not going to get it, okay? Then I also mentioned about net foreign exchange earnings, right? So what is net foreign exchange earnings here? It's nothing but the gross earnings of foreign exchange. Then in that process, you would have incurred some expenses, right? So from that, minus total expenses or payment or remittances of foreign exchange. So gross earnings of foreign exchange, that is your inflow side. And on the outflow side, the expenses incurred related to that or payment related to that or remittances of foreign exchange, these got to be deducted. So you get your net foreign exchange earnings. Fine. Moving on. Let's have a look at the duty credit script here. See, this duty credit script you can get at some notified rates. Let's say you make a particular value of export. So on that, by applying that notified rate, you get your duty credit script. So it is mentioned that exporter is entitled to duty credit script at notified rates on net foreign exchange earned. And this duty credit script can be used for paying customs duties, excise duties. Now, he can also use this. I mean, the exporter can also use this in case of default in fulfillment of export obligation under advance authorization, EPCG and all. And these duty credit scripts are also freely transferable. It means if the exporter is having duty credit script, but he has no other obligation immediately, let's say like payment of customs duties, then he can also transfer and encash this. Okay, let's look at the eligible categories for service export from India scheme. Because in the beginning I said only notified services are eligible. So what is that? That's what we are going to see. Eligible categories for service export from India scheme and the rate. Look at this. You can see the category of services. Professional services. The rate of reward is 5 to 7%. So whatever the net foreign exchange income on that 5 to 7%, it varies. Okay. So that's going to be the rate of reward. Then research and development services, audio visual services, construction and related engineering services. So these are all the eligible categories. Like that you can see educational services, recreational, cultural and sporting services, transport and auxiliary services, rental leasing services without operators, environmental services, health related. So the list goes and the percentages also vary. See, the majority of the percentages are 5 to 7, but if you look at tourism and travel and other business services, it's like 3 to 7 and 3 to 5%. So it could vary depending upon the category. And off late, there is a significant takeoff in online teaching. And we sitting in India, we have students across the world, okay? And their export of services takes place. So that comes under educational services. So we can also make use of it, right? So like that, for each and every services, whatever the services that are listed, if they are into export, they can make use of this. Then, what are the activities that are ineligible under ACIS scheme? So we should be very clear about that as well. What are they? Whatever the services which are other than those earned for rendering of notified services, because already we have seen the notified services just now, okay? So whatever services other than this, they are ineligible under the scheme. Then the foreign exchange earnings, let's say foreign exchange coming in the form of equity or debt participation or donations or say a receipt of repayment of loans, all these are ineligible. Okay, so all these are about services. Next, we'll move on to mechanized exports from India scheme, MEIS. This is for export of goods. Let's see. This scheme was introduced to incentivize the exporter who is exporting eligible goods from India. So what are those eligible goods? That is a big list. Let's see. So this scheme is available for manufacturer, exporter and traders also. Manufacturer, exporter and traders also. And I said there are eligible goods. It means there are more than 5,000 export items. So that's a very, very comprehensive list. We have to look at it. So on this, when goods are exported, the duty credit scripts are available. And this credit scripts can be used for making payment of customs duties, let's say for import of inputs or goods and all. Let me just show you few of the eligible category of goods. It can be like edible items, then you can see inorganic chemicals, organic or inorganic compounds, pharmaceutical products, photographic, cinematographic goods, plastic, raw hides. The list goes, okay, because I said it's 5,000 items and I'm just listing out few of them here. Okay, so the list goes and we have listed 19, okay, right. And what is the nature of reward here? See, this duty credit script is granted as a reward under this scheme, MEIS, and this can be used when goods are imported and customs duties have to be paid, and these scripts are also freely transferable. Okay, what about the rate of rewards? Because in services, we have seen the categories, we have seen the rates like 5 to 7%, then 3 to 7% and all, right? So under MEIS scheme, what are the rates? See, it actually depends upon the nature of the item, and it also depends upon the place or country to which goods are being exported. Fine. So this is all about the duty credit scripts I wanted to explain. So if you are into export, please be aware of this, because if you come under eligible category, okay, if you come under the notified services, or if you are exporting the notified goods, then you can claim this duty credit script, which you can use for, let's say, paying your import duties, or if you don't have any other obligation, it is also transferable. You can encash it as well. Thank you.